So what is a UPS, or uninterruptible power supply? An uninterruptible power supply is a device that is used to keep computers and equipment safe when there is a loss or a significant reduction in the primary power source. To achieve this, the UPS houses several batteries that take over when it detects a loss or reduction in available power. Once this is detected, the control is transferred over to the batteries, and via an inverter, the battery's DC voltage is converted into AC for the devices. In reality, it doesn't have to be computer systems and equipment that are kept alive by UPS. It could be anything from a fish tank to a foot massager. We aren't just talking about plain power outages, lights off, TV off, everything, but we can sometimes get spikes in power where a sudden drop can assure our devices are momentarily powered off, or something known as a brownout. This is where there is a voltage drop, either unintentionally or intentionally. Sometimes in an emergency, there is a load reduction, caused intentionally. With a UPS, all of our systems can run as normal to compensate for the reduction in power. Clever! Before we get started on today's video, if you love our videos, be sure to click the like button below. Then make sure to click subscribe and the little bell to receive notifications of new RealParz videos. This way, you never miss another one. The amount of time the UPS can sustain a system for can vary, but it allows the opportunity for the issue to be resolved, or at the very least, allows for the systems to be shut down in a controlled manner. Even the simplest UPS is made up of a number of parts. We're going to look at the standard parts that you can find in a basic UPS system. Since a UPS is a system that uses batteries to power a system, should the supply be compromised, we, of course, have batteries and a battery charger. Since the batteries use DC current and our incoming supply is AC current, we need to convert DC to AC using an inverter. Finally, we need a way of switching between the AC incoming supply and battery power. For this, we use something called a transfer switch. So, to break it down, these are the parts we need for a basic UPS system: batteries, battery charger, inverter, and transfer switch. A UPS provides second-level surge protection, but although it does provide some protection, it should usually be used alongside an adequate surge protection device, or SPD, to extend the life of the UPS, as well as the attached equipment. Sounds simple, right? We've already discovered a basic UPS system, and what parts it includes. Now, we're going to find out all about the different types of uninterruptible power supplies, and what their typical functions are. Firstly, and the most common in smaller systems, is the standby or offline UPS. This is the one you would normally use on a personal computer, for example. The standby UPS lays in wait for its time to spring into action, and once there's a power failure, it takes control. The standby UPS tends to be the most cost-effective UPS available. Next up, we have the line interactive UPS. You'll find this type of UPS in small business infrastructure. It is very similar to a standby UPS, but with the added ability to regulate voltage automatically. This means that it monitors the incoming supply and can help out if it detects that the voltage is a bit low, or a spike is causing it to go too high. It can add or subtract power in this way to make the output to our devices constant. Very smart. This type of UPS is particularly useful for the brownout situation we've already mentioned, or power spikes or surges. Now, we have the online double conversion UPS. Don't let the name put you off. This type of UPS is efficient as the primary source of power isn't the incoming supply. Rather, it is the battery power. So when we have a power outage, there's no transfer switch to close, meaning no time to switch that you can get with the other type of UPSs. When the incoming supply is on, the batteries simply charge up. It's called a double conversion because it converts the AC incoming supply to DC, and then the inverter converts it back to AC for the output. In general, it ensures a far higher degree of isolation of the load from the irregularities on the main supply. These are the most common types of UPS available. Of course, there are other types that fit a particular form or function, but these tend to be for more specialist needs. In summary, today we've learned about uninterruptible power supplies. We've learned that they can be used as a backup to mains power in an emergency situation, such as a power outage. More advanced UPSs can regulate the voltage to prevent damage to equipment in case of a brownout or a power surge. We now have a good understanding of what parts are used to make up a UPS: batteries, a battery charger, inverter, and a transfer switch. Finally, we know that an online double conversion UPS is the most efficient, as it doesn't need a transfer switch as the primary source of the power goes through the batteries. That's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed learning about UPS systems, why we use them, and what they're used for. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you've learned something new from this video, it would mean the world to us to like this video. And if you can think of anything you'd like us to cover, let us know in the comments, and we'll see if we can put together a video on your topic too. Catch us next time for another informative video. That's it for now. Want to learn PLC programming in an easy-to-understand format and take your career to the next level? Head on over to realpars.com.